This video is about our scissor lifts. Both our low-rise scissor lifts, as we have them here and there many different iterations, and also our double scissor lifts. Let's start with this one here. This is our TWS310E. Over here we have the TWS3.510E and the TWS310ESZ. A few words about the name. TWS310E means scissor lift, 3 tons, 1 meter lifting height, electromagnetic safety release. As you would have guessed, the S3.510E has a lifting capacity of 3.5 tons, also 1 meter lifting height, and the electromagnetic safety release as well. The FZ model is basically the same as the S310E. With the small difference that both the control unit and the scissor lift are completely galvanized. This makes the lift ideal for generally damp rooms like car washes, for example. Of course, I have the huge advantage that a scissor lift generally doesn't require much space. Especially with the low-rise models, with which I can also acquire the optional mobile kit, I obviously don't have a fixed place where the lift always has to be because I can't move them from one place to the other with the mobile kit. Besides that, our scissor lifts have a very low drive-over height. These three models have a drive-over height of only 11 centimeters. Of course, another big advantage of this type of scissor lift is the vehicle reception. Here we have the access ramps, which also work as an extension. So, if I have lowered the lift completely, I can use them as access ramps. But when my car is already placed and it's a bit longer, then I can raise them. They lock themselves down here at the same time. And then I can place my rubber pad here for longer vehicles. It looks like this. To lift my vehicle, I now put one here and one over here. It's no problem to lift like this. These ramps or extensions are completely capable of carrying load. Therefore, I can easily support a vehicle on the ramps because they are secured individually here. Another huge benefit is that the scissor lifts are freely accessible. That means, when I have my car on the lift, I can access it easily from this side, from the front, the back, and from anywhere, without having to twist myself in any big way. Of course, this is very practical for people who want to use the lift for vehicle preparation, varnishes, polishes, etc. Everything that's made on the vehicle and takes place at this height. Tire changing, for example, is also very easy with this lift, because the working height is decisive for it. And, of course, it's ideal because my wheel would be approximately here at this height when my car is lifted. Another important aspect worth mentioning is that all our scissor lifts have a double line system. What is a double line system? Simply put, two hoses go from the motor unit towards the two different cylinders. This ensures that the system's oil pressure is divided evenly between the two cylinders so that, for example, this side doesn't fill up first and then the other one is to somehow drag along, but rather that the pressure is divided evenly into the cylinders. Furthermore, all of our scissor lifts are equipped with these grease nipples in all the important points, so that the lift can be greased relatively easily, whether it's here on the different screw connections, or here by the contact points where the movement happens. There are grease nipples installed everywhere so that performing my lift's maintenance is relatively easy to do, and it can be actually done by anyone who has such a grease gun. A few words about the differences between the S310E and the S3.510E. Maybe you can see it already, this lift is 20 centimeters wider here in the middle. Which logically also allows me to lift wider vehicles with this lift. Besides that, as the name suggests and as I already mentioned, this lift can lift 500 kilograms more than the other model. Here's the control unit of the S310E. We have a fairly normal power switch. An up button to raise the lift, a down button to lower the lift, and an emergency stop button. Now we see the control unit of S3.510E, which is basically built in the same way. The control unit of the S3.510E is obviously optically different to the one from the S310E. As you can see, this unit is completely closed. Here's the control unit of the S310EFZ, that is the galvanized model. In terms of structure, it is identical to that of the S310E, with the difference that this one is completely galvanized. Something that must be also mentioned is that the S310E as well as the S3.510E are available in 230 and 400 volts, but the S310EFZ is only available in 400 volts. Here are our double scissor lifts now, the TWS318U and the TWS319. What does double scissor lift mean? It means that, in contrast to the lifts we just saw, these lifts have a double scissor system, which simply allows us to lift even higher with them. Briefly about the name, TWS318U means scissor lift, 3 tons, 1.8 meters lifting height, underfloor model in this case, that means level with the ground, and TWS319 means scissor lift, 3 tons, 1.9 meters lifting height, above floor model in this case, so not like the S318U. I have to drive onto this lift. Both lifts are conceived so that I can work under the vehicle due to the higher lifting height. Unlike other scissor lifts, I can work easily under the car when the lift is completely raised, to install an exhaust system for example. The TWS319 also has a rocker arm system here. The rocker arm system is basically there to transform a horizontal movement and a vertical movement. Both double scissor lifts also have a photoelectric barrier system. That means there's a sensor here, which is reflected over here. And if the platforms were being lifted unevenly, the lift would stop in that case because the light barrier would be interrupted. I need a compressed air connection to unlock both of these lifts. That means compressed air is supplied here so that this carriage can jump and my lift can go down without locking into the safety catches. Unlike the other scissor lifts, the S318U has an expandable platform to simply save some space in the foundation. As the name suggests, I can simply pull here to expand my platform. If I have longer vehicles, then I simply pull it further. If I have shorter vehicles, I can either leave it in or pull it out just a bit. It is adjustable. The TWS319 has the same access ramps as the low-rise scissor lifts, and also the same drive over height of 11 centimeters. This is the control unit of the TWS319 and TWS318U. I can control the whole lift automatically from here. We have an up button which logically raises the lift. Then we have two different down buttons. The reason for that is that with down one the lift is lowered to a height of 60 centimeters. Then I can control once more that nothing is obstructing the path of the lift. That is no tools, no hands, no feet. If I have checked that and everything is okay, then I can use down 2 to lower the lift all the way down. With the lock button I can lower the lift onto the next safety catch. That means, when I push here, the safety locks are not released, and I can use the lift to keep the car there for a longer time and to simply relieve the hydraulic cylinders. The double scissor lifts are available in 400 volts and in 230 volts by request. Both our low-rise and double scissor lifts are suitable for lifting cars starting at the size of approximately a Volkswagen Polo. From there it's no problem at all whether it's a middle-class SUV or a big limousine like an Audi R8 for example. We have no problems then. There are also optionally available cross beams, which can be used for a Mercedes G-Class for example, or generally for ladder frame vehicles. And we also offer platform extensions, which I would need to lift a vehicle like a Volkswagen T5 for example. There are also optionally available access ramps for the low-rise scissor lifts and for the TWS319. they work well if you have an extremely low vehicle, so that the approach angle is reduced further and you can drive the car easily onto the lift. I hope I could help you a bit further with this video. You now have the option of choosing a suitable lift below if you have already decided on a specific model. Among other things, you'll find individual product videos and assembly videos for each lift. If you still have any questions or doubts, then you can always give us a call. Either I or one of my colleagues will help you further with any specific questions. Otherwise, thanks for watching.